This chapter covers writing reports, MLA format, and also some really great formatting techniques that you need to be able to adapt to. So let's go through some of those formatting techniques and get you started. First off, you're going to be doing a header on your report, and that header is right aligned. And so you're going to come up here, you're going to hit right aligned. Oh, how did I get in the header? I'm sure you're just now wondering. I have a tricky way to get in, and I found out a long time ago that if I'm looking at my ruler bars, and let's go back here to uncheck, those are the ruler bars I'm referring to. Notice this gray area, that's outside the margin. Okay, the white area is inside the margin. So I'm going outside the margin and it's in the header, and I can just double click and that'll take me in the header. So I'm in. The way the book is telling you to do it is to go to design and click on header, or insert header. I think you can go into, there's an insert header command right here, and it will take you there as well. So because I'm in design now, I can close my header in the design menu. But what I want to do now is to right align my text. So I'm going to come here and right align it. Then I'm going to type in my name, space, and I want to put in the page number. Well, Word will automatically number your pages, so you don't want to type a page number in. And so where I'm going again is, let's go into insert, and we have page number, and it's at the current position. Remember, I typed my last name and put in an enter, or not a space, so that it has a space after it. And now when I put in current position, it comes in with my last name and a space. Another thing that's happening here is you're looking at your show hide view. So if I was to take off this show hide feature, you'll see that it has my last name in the space. Now I'm going to come out of the header and I'm back into my document. Now what I need to change is the default paragraph settings for the type. And the settings for the document. Because this is an MLA report, I want to come into the normal template, right click it, and modify it. And what I'm saying is, okay, I only want this to go into this document. I want it to be Times New Roman. I want it to be 12 points. And that's about as far as we're going to go for this particular part of that activity. So I'm just going to click on OK. And that's the new style for this particular document. Now I need to save my document. And as you can see, I have saved my document as U04A1 headphones and earbuds paper. And I put it in my U04A1 folder. So I click on Save. And here I am. Now the next part of this process is to enter your student name, and they have you use Oswald Carter, but I'm going to put in my name. And oh, I haven't done one other part of the formatting, and that is the paragraph formatting, because right now the paragraph formatting is single spaced. My report needs to be double spaced. And I don't want any extra space when I hit enter. So if I was to look at my line spacing, the default always comes in with single, with every time you hit enter, you get 12 points after. So I'm going to change that 12 points to 0, and I'm going to change my line spacing to double. And that's just about where I want to go with that. And now when I hit enter, I can finish off my format for my paper. And CIS 210. And now the date. The book has you put in October 10th, 2017. Well, I'm going to show you one other date option that's real nice, because I can never remember what date I'm working on my papers. So I work on insert, and I come up to date and time. And you can see right here, I can click on the month, day, year, and that's what I want to put in this particular format. And I'm not going to have it update automatically because I just want it to be today's date. And it's going to take whatever today's date is and insert it into my paper. Now I hit enter one more time and I proceed to type the paper. So I'm going to pause this through the magic of my computer. Okay, my paper is now typed and ready to format. The first thing that I'm going to do is to take and center my heading. And I want to check on one other thing. I want to come up here into my home ribbon band and see what is the format, or it's under references. Ah, this is APA style. I'm working on MLA style, so I need to make sure that this is MLA. And I've got the right information in there, because when I start to generate my bibliography or my works cited page, it's going to make a huge difference. MLA's works cited are different than APA works cited. All right, so first here I am, and I want to grab this title and center it. Then come up and tab the individual paragraphs. And how do I know where these are? First off, I want to give you your show hide button again. Every time I typed a full paragraph, I just let the text wrap around on its own. And when I was done with that paragraph, I hit enter. So that's how I know, is these enters. So I can come here and there's a tab in front of this one and a tab here. And notice no extra spacing. It's all just double spaced throughout. And that's what I'm supposed to do. This one has some mark on here that I don't want, so I'm going to backspace that out. Okay, so now I'm looking at the basic report, ready to go into the next phase of setting up the report. We are eventually going to be typing in these three references, but in the beginning, they're only having you type in two. This is the first one. It's an article in a periodical, and these are the specifications that they give you. Notice a couple things. This one doesn't have a page and it is web related. The trend today is to tell you not to put the URL in on the website. Personally, I do most of my papers in APA style, and I like to have the URL there because I like to be able to backtrack and reference that URL, but they're telling you not to do that because the URLs change all the time. So they're just telling you the medium is the web. Okay, so let's go into this other one, which is this one. And that's the second reference that they tell you to put in. So, and just to make this other process easier, I'm going to remove the one that I've already got in there. The next part of this process is going to be to put in your footnotes. And in order to put the footnotes in, you need to know about how to input the information. Number one, you don't want to have any space after the period, okay? Number two, you're just going to type the footnote and then you can do your formatting afterwards. But so my footnote is going to go into after the word, this paragraph on technology, after the word technology. Now, all I have to do is click on insert footnote and see what it does is it brings the footnote feature and it also brings the reference. But now I need to do the typing. Through the magic of the computer, I just did a copy paste, but there's something wrong with this one in that it needs to be reformatted. So what I've got to do is highlight it and go to the style and tell it, okay, this is a footnote style. So this is good. That part of it is good, but I got to modify this style because I want to do it for an MLA format. So it needs to be 12 points on the Times New Roman. I also need to go to the paragraph and make it so that it indents the first line and that it's double spaced. So everything in this MLA report is double spaced. And so I click on OK. And OK again. And now that document, that part of the document is double spaced as well. And I've got that indent on the footnote. Now this is where why I had to erase that other one. The next process is that I needed to insert a new placeholder, and it's for the new reference, which is the GUPTA reference. If I already had that, had the reference in there, it's not going to work properly. So I've got my placeholder, and then I've got to go into my manage my sources and add that source. And I believe I've already got it in here. No, I got to type it. So give me a second and I'll type it up for you. Got my cart before my horse here. What I need to do is take and edit the source from the placeholder that I just put in. So we edit the source, and this is where we put in that it's a book. And we've got two authors in this book. So we go to edit, and then we have an option to add the two authors. Okay, I've added one of the authors. This is the second, just to show you the process. I've added, this is the second author, and I'd add his name, and then I click OK. Okay, this is the remainder of the specifications you're putting in on this particular author. And you'll see that you've just put in all of the information here, and what's going to happen down here for the citations after I've edited this source. See, now it's put in both authors. Now the tricky part that we've got to do next is to edit the citation again. And this time we're going to put in the pages as 75 through 78, and we're going to suppress the author. So that, and suppress the title. So what's going to happen now when you've edited this citation is it's just going to bring those page numbers in there. Now that whole process is really tricky, I know, and a lot of people have trouble with it. You should note that once you've inserted that page number, you want to put a period after your citation. Now what we're going to do is insert a citation. And again, you need to place your cursor in the proper area. And this citation is after the word volume on this paragraph. So, and all I have to do is click on insert citation, and we find the citation is Chamberlain. And then a period comes after the citation reference. And now, you might have noticed also one of the things that I mentioned in the book are the automatic page breaks and whether you want to have a hard page break or not. But what we're going to do is we're going to make a hard page break. And one of the things that happens with these that people don't realize is, okay, I got to get down to that last page. How do I get there? The most common mistake that I see is people hit enter like this until they get to the end of the page and it just transfers over to a new page. Don't do that, please. I'll mark you down every time. You should be putting in a hard page break. Now you can do that through two different methods. There's always two or three to use, but this one you could do the insert and it's page break right here, and that'll work. Or what I always use is this other method, control plus the return button. So I just hit, hold down my control key and hit enter, and that gives me my new page. And that's what we want to work on. That's what you want to do. Now we're going to generate the Works Cited page from this. And we're doing that with by just going up to the area, since we have in our references all these sources that have been used, all we have to do is go to the bibliography option and choose the works cited option. And there we are. Now our works cited for this should be again Times New Roman. So if I look here, it's Times New Roman here, but not here. I've got a heading style and I don't want that. So that should be Times New Roman and back to 12 points and we're good and no color. So it's just the automatic color. Now let's come through and follow through with our double spacing. With no space after, remove, oh, this has got a space before, so no space before. So there should not be any spaces before or after, and it should be, this should be a zero here, and it has this outdent, which is correct, and it's a double space. So it should look like that. It had some extra spacing that came in there that we didn't want. Now this is your title, and that is centered. But notice some of the other things that came through because this was MLA style. Let's go back so that you're not having to look at my, okay. Notice some of the other things that, okay, not number one, you've got your hearing and understanding volume levels is italicized. That's the title of your book, okay? Your author's names are alphabetized. So it's in ascending order, alphabetically. And then you have all your correct settings for your page numbers and those types of things. This is what you need to really look at because this is what your English teachers are going to be looking at. So you need to know these details. I cannot stress it enough. So I'm going to save this one. I do want to note that everything that I've done in this video is not all of the detail that you're learning in the chapter because you're also learning about the autocorrect feature and spell check and the thesaurus, and I will go over that a little bit more, but I thought you needed to have this formatting in a separate video. So I'm going to save this now and tell you to have a nice day.